So over to you, Tarika.
Good afternoon, guests. Today, we all are going to learn about the country Libya. I will start with a small introduction about the Libya. Libya is the country. Next slide, please. Okay, Libya is the country in the Maghreb region in North Africa, bordered by the Mediterranean Sea to the north, Egypt to the east, Sudan to the southeast, Chad to the south, Niger to the southwest, Algeria to the west, and Tunisia to the northwest. Libya comprises three historical regions: Tripolitanian in the historical northwest, Cyrenaica in the east, and Fezza in the southwest. Libya has the area almost 7 lakh square miles, and Libya is the fourth largest country in Africa, and the 16th largest city and capital is Tripoli, and which is located in the western Libya and contains over 3 million of people. Now we will learn about the flag of Libya, capital of Libya, and currency of Libya. Libya flag, as you all can see, the flag consisting of pan-Arab colors. Now you all are confused. What is pan-Arab colors? The pan-Arab colors are black, white, green, and red. Individually, each of the color represent historical Arab dynasty. The black was the Abbas dynasty color, white was the Umayyad dynasty color, green was the Fatimid dynasty color, and red was the Hashemite dynasty color. Now we'll know about the currency. Libya currency is Libyan dinar, and one Libya dinar equals to 16.52 Indian rupee. Libya capital is Tripoli, which is, I've already told, which is situated in the northwestern Libya, along with the Mediterranean coast. And it is the country's largest city and chief seaport. The official language is Arabic, and the government is unitary provisional, unitary government. And the president of the Libya is Mohammed El Menfi. Next slide, please. In Libya, there are total 18 airports. We will not gonna learn about total 18 airports, all the 18 airports, but some of the main airports. Next slide, please. First airport is Tripoli Airport, which is also known as Mitiga International Airport, and it is the largest airport in Libya. Tripoli Airport has non-stop passenger flights scheduled to 8 destinations in 4 countries. Airport type is joint and public and military. Joint hai, it is public and military both. At present, there are 2 domestic flights from Tripoli. Next slide, please. It is Benghazi Airport, also known as Benin International Airport, is the second largest airport in Libya. And it is the international airport and serves area in Benghazi, Libya. Benghazi Airport has non-stop passenger flights scheduled to 7 destinations in 2 countries. At present, there are 5 domestic flights from Benghazi. The runway length does not include 300 meters, which is, you can say, 980 feet, overrun on the end of each runway. Next slide, please. Kufra Airport, also known as Kufra Airport, is a small airport in Libya with domestic flights only. Kufra Airport has non-stop passenger flights scheduled to only 1 destination. At present, there is 1 domestic flight from Kufra. Next slide, please. Misurata. Misurata Airport, also known as Misrata Airport, is the third largest airport in Libya. It is an international airport and serves the area of Misurata, Libya. Misurata Airport has four destinations in three countries. It is the non-passenger flights. At present, there is domestic flight from Misurata. There is only one domestic flight from Misurata. Next slide, please. In the slides, you can see many of the airports of Libya, like Brek Airport, Khadmeis Airport, Khat Airport, Horn Airport, Labrak Airport, Marsa Berga Airport, Fartuba Airport, Mitiga Airport. You have all heard about the Mitiga Airport, Murzak Airport, Nafura Airport, Sirte Airport, Tobruk Airport, and Ubari Airport. Now, next slide, please. Now, we will learn about the Libya Zoo. Next slide. Tripoli Zoo. The airport is also, this is the capital, Tripoli, and you have learned about the Tripoli Airport. Now, we will learn about the Tripoli Zoo. Tripoli Zoo is a zoological garden and botanical garden in Tripoli, Libya. Located south of Tripoli city centers and adjacent to Tarabulla Zoo Park. It is the large serve to plant trees and open green spaces and is the country's biggest zoo. Next slide. Benghazi Zoo. You have already learned about the Benghazi airport. This is the Benghazi Zoo. Benghazi Zoo or El Fuayat Zoo, established in 1956, is a zoo and a tourist park in the city of Benghazi, Libya. In 1991, Italian firm Catherini Trieste signed a $2 million contract to supply a low dot boat named El Berka.
Excuse me,
to
ma'am.
Give tour. Yes.
Ma'am, which country today we are going? We are traveling.
Libya. Libya. L-I-B-Y-A.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, this is the second zoo name?
Yes, Benghazi. First, it was Tripoli Zoo.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
I'll continue. In 1999, Italian firm Cattle Zinc signed a $2 billion contract to such a low draught boat named El Berka to give tourist excursions on the lagoon inside the park. But now they call it El Bosco. Next slide. Now we'll see some videos on the zoo and then we will continue with the presentations. Can we have the video, please? There might be some mistake with the video. At the end, we will play the videos, all the videos, okay? Now, we will continue with the presentations. We will see some beautiful... one minute only, we are resharing the screen. So, do you have heard about the Sahara Desert? Anyone know some fun facts about the Sahara
Desert? He is the largest desert in the world.
Okay, yes,
it
great.
Is 9 lakh kilometers.
Yes.
No.
Anything else?
Ma'am, it is the hottest desert in the world.
Yes, yes, right.
Ma'am, there are so many.
Okay, we will continue. We will continue our learning. Now, we will learn about the Jebel Akhdar. Jabal-e-Akhdar is the one of the district of Libya. It lies on the northeast of the country. The capital is Baida. The Jebel-e-Akhdar, also known as Green Mountain, is a heavy forested fertile upland area in northeastern Libya. It is located in the modern Sabyasis or district of Derna, Jabal-e-Akhdar and Merj. How high is Jabal-e-Akhdar? You know, it is 3,000 meter. Next slide, please. Wow and Namus. Wow and Namus, also spelled Von and Namus, is a volcano in Libya. It is one of the most remote places on earth. It is the middle of the Sahara and hundreds of kilometers from a settlement. It's also a place with plenty of water because its volcanic crater reaches deep down to the level of the ground aquifer. Now we will see some videos about these places to know them more. Can I have the video, please?
Ma'am? All the animals are known to you?
One is Green Mamba.
Yeah. We have discussed it yesterday, right? Now let us continue. Yes?
मैम क्या हमने एयरपोर्ट के वीडियोस देख लिए
व्हाट यू आर सेइंग प्लीज रिपीट
मैम वी हैव सीन एयरपोर्ट्स वीडियो
No, we did not find any airport videos because in Libya there is a war situations happened. So that's why we did not find any good videos. So that's why we are not showing you a video.
Okay, ma'am.
We have
okay,
only
ma'am.
The video of zoo and the tourist places. As there are not amusement park, we did not find amusement park. There are amusement park in Libya, but we did not find any image and the good content about it. So that's why in our PPT, we include the tourist places like Sahara Desert, Wow and Namus. These places we have included in the our today's session.
Okay, ma'am.
I hope I clear all your doubts.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, guest, for giving your valuable time. And you all were the great listeners. And I hope you have got some knowledge about the country Libya. And have a great day ahead.
Ma'am, which is the next country?
Madagascar.
Okay.
Member,
which country?
Madagascar. I have a task for you that you have to search about this country, like some facts or anything famous in this country, and anything you want to share it in the next class. So can you do it for me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that's all about our today's session. Hope you like or hope you enjoyed our today's tour.
Yes, ma'am. I enjoyed very much.
Okay. So see you at Monday.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Take care.
Have a very nice day, ma'am.